Welcome to our new lesson, Tenses. Today, we are going to give you a basic overview of tense system and then we will proceed to simple present tense. Tenses tell us the time of an action. Always remember, tenses will give you information about time of an action being done. And we know that action means, action words are called as verb. When the action is done now, action is done in the previous period, or action will be done in the upcoming period. This time of an action represent tense. And according to this, there are three types of tense: past tense, present tense and future tense. Let us understand what is past tense, what is present tense and what is future tense. In the example one, you can see the boy went to the market. Jo ladka hai wo market gaya tha, ye ho chuka hai. The action is over in the previous period. So such type of action is called as past tense. जो action हो चुका है उसे क्या कहते हैं? Past tense. In the second example, you can see the boy eats an ice cream. जो लड़का है वो ice cream खाता है. So this action is done now. ये action कब हो रहा है? अभी हो रहा है. So this action is called as present tense. These types of action are called as present tense. In the third example, you can see the boy will go for shopping. जो लड़का है वो शॉपिंग करने जाने वाला है. ये एक्शन बाद में होगा. दिस एक्शन विल बी टेकिंग प्लेस इन द फ्यूचर. सो सच टाइप ऑफ टेंसेस आर कॉल्ड एज फ्यूचर टेंस. सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ टेंस: प्रेजेंट टेंस, पास्ट टेंस एंड फ्यूचर टेंस. नाउ अगेन वी विल सी दिस टेंसेस आर सब डिवाइडेड इंटू four parts. Present tense is subdivided into four parts, past tense is subdivided into four parts and future tense is subdivided into four parts. How they are subdivided, let us see. Now as you can see, we are having three types of tense, that is present tense, past tense and future tense. And the subdivision of present, past and future tense are simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. Let us understand what is simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. Simple tense usually refers to a single action. Simple tense जो है वो बस एक single action के बारे में बताता है. In general, simple tense express facts and situation that existed in past, exist in present or will exist in future. सिंपल टेंस जो है वो हमें एक सिचुएशन के बारे में बताता है या फिर फैक्ट के बारे में बताता है जो प्रेजेंट में होता है, पास्ट में होता है और फ्यूचर में होता है. एंड वी नो दैट देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ टेंस: प्रेजेंट टेंस, पास्ट टेंस एंड फ्यूचर टेंस. सो द सब डिविजन इज सिंपल. सो सिंपल प्लस प्रेजेंट, सिंपल प्रेजेंट, सिंपल प्लस पास्ट, सिंपल पास्ट एंड सिंपल एंड फ्यूचर, सिंपल future tense. The next one is continuous tense. We use continuous tense to talk about an unfinished event. जब कोई कार्य नहीं होता है, वो आधा अधूरा होता है, दैट टाइम वी यूज कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. एंड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, इन कंटिन्यूअस टेंस वी हैव टू यूज आई एन जी. इन कंटिन्यूअस टेंस वी हैव टू यूज आई एन जी. एंड वी नो दैट देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ टेंस: प्रेजेंट, पास्ट एंड फ्यूचर. सो प्रेजेंट प्लस कंटिन्यूअस, प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस, पास्ट एंड कंटिन्यूअस, पास्ट कंटिन्यूअस, फ्यूचर एंड कंटिन्यूअस, फ्यूचर कंटिन्यूअस. द थर्ड वन इज परफेक्ट. दे एक्सप्रेस द आइडिया दैट वन इवेंट हैपेंड बिफोर एंड अनदर. जब एक इवेंट कि पहले और एक इवेंट होता है, दैट टाइम वी यूज परफेक्ट टेंस. सो प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट, पास्ट परफेक्ट, फ्यूचर परफेक्ट. एंड द फोर्थ वन इज परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस. परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस एक्सप्रेस ड्यूरेशन और हाउ लॉन्ग, कितने टाइम में हो रहा है. इट यूजुअली इंक्लूड्स द एडवर्ब फॉर और सिंस. इन दिस परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस यू विल गेट एडवर्ब सच एज फॉर और सिंस. सो present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous and future perfect continuous. So the subdivisions are four: simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. So simple present, simple past, simple future. Present continuous, past continuous and future continuous. Present perfect, past perfect and future perfect. Present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous and future perfect continuous. Now we will see the rules of present, past and future. We know that there are three types of tense: present tense, past tense and future tense. And the subdivision of present tense, there are four parts: past tense four parts and future tense four parts. Means total there are 12 tenses. And and you have to remember 12 rules. But it is not hard to remember 12 rules if you understand the rules in present tense. That is simple present, present continuous, present perfect and present perfect continuous. You can relate it with present tense and you can form past tense. You can relate it with present tense and you can form future tense. So what you need to understand the rules in present tense and how to relate with in present with past and present with future, then you will tell tenses is the easiest part in grammar. So without wasting our time, let us see what are the rules of present tense. So the first one is simple present. In simple present tense, we use V1 plus SES. V1 form, forms of verb we have seen in my last video. If you have not seen, the link is in description box, you can go through it. Now, V1 form, if we take example of sing, sang, sung. V1 sing, V2 sang, V3 sung. Similarly, drink, V1 drank, V2 and drunk, V3. And also we have to use yes or es. S or es is used in third person singular that we will see further. The next one is continuous, present continuous. In present continuous tense, we have to use is, am, are plus V1 plus ing. Here in continuous tense, you have to use is, am, are plus V1 form. And you know now what is V1 form plus ing. Always remember, whenever there is continuous tense, you have to use ing form. Whenever there is continuous tense, you have to use ing form. The third one is perfect. In perfect tense, you have to use has have. Has have means perfect tense. You have to remember like that. Has have means perfect tense. Now, in perfect tense, we have to use V3 form. In perfect tense, we have to use V3 form. And the fourth one is perfect continuous. Perfect means we have to use has have continuous. Been plus V1 plus ing. What is the rule? Has have plus been plus V1 plus ing. So it is very easy to remember. Simple present means you have to use V1 form plus S or ES. And where to use S or ES, we will see in our further classes. Continuous tense is, am, are. You have to use is, am, are plus V1 plus ing. I have made lesson on is, am, are, how to use, where to use is, where to use am and where to use are. The link is in description box, you can see if you have not seen that video. Next one is in perfect tense, we have to use has and have. So perfect tense, and I have also made video where to use has and have, you can go through in the description box. Plus V3 form, perfect continuous, has have plus been plus V1 plus ing. Only you remember 4 rules today. Then if you understand these 4 rules, you can relate it with past tense and you can relate it with future tense. Now let us see what is the rules in past tense. As we have seen, in simple present tense we use V1 form. So similarly, in past tense we have to use, instead of V1 form we will use V2 form because it is past. So in present we are using V1 form, in past we will use V2 form. Next, present continuous we are using is, am, are. The past of is, am, are becomes was, were. So is, am, are, instead of using is, am, are, what we have to use? Was or were. Where to use was, where to use were, you can see in description box, okay, link is there. Next, plus V1 plus ing, same. In present continuous also we have seen V1 plus ing. Only the difference is, instead of using is, am, are, you have to use was or were. Third one, in present perfect tense we have used has or have plus V3. So the past of has and have is had. So in past perfect tense we have to use had plus V3. Same. Instead of using has or have, the past of that one is had. So had plus V3. Similarly, present perfect continuous tense we have used has have plus been plus V1 plus ing. So instead of using has have, we have to use had because it is past, plus been plus V1 plus ing, same. So only what you have to do, you remember only one. First you remember present tense, all the 4 rules: present simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect and present perfect continuous tense. When you will know all these 4 rules in the present, you can know past tense also. And when you will know this present tense, past tense, you will know future tense. Now let us see what are the rules in future tense. future tense. In simple present tense, we used V1 form. So same thing we have to use in future tense V1 form. But in future tense, we have to use will or shall. And where to use will or shall, that we will see in our further classes. Only you have to remember, if a sentence has will or shall, then it is future tense. Now, same V1 form we are using, next one we will see. Future continuous tense. In present tense, we have used is, am, are. Here, what we will use be. Be, and same V1 plus ing. And we know in future tense, we are using will or shall. Next one is perfect tense. In present tense, we have used has or have plus V3 form. Same thing, will and shall, it is common in future tense. We are not using has, we are only using have. Have plus V3, same. In perfect tense, you have to use V3 form. You can see in present also we are using V3 form, past also we are using V3 form, and future. Means perfect tense means you have to use V3 form. Next is present perfect continuous. We have used has or have plus been plus V1 plus ing. Here same we have to use will and shall, that is common. Plus we are not using has, we are only using have. Plus been plus V1 plus ing. So what you have to remember here, in perfect tense we are using been, B-E-E-N, been plus V1 plus ing. And I have said continuous tense means ing will come. So it was very easy to understand the rules of present tense, past tense and future tense. What you need to do, only remember four rules in the present. Then you relate it with present tense and make it past tense. And then you relate it with present tense and make future tense rules. And when you remember all these 12 rules and you will understand, you can say easily what type of tenses you are seeing. You can change the tenses very easily. So it is not hard. Try to remember these 12 rules. One by one we will see. Today we will see present simple present tense. What is simple present tense? How we are using S and ES and the test series. Simple present tense. It shows an action in present. It tells us that an action is done as a habit or something that is always true. So, simple present tense tells us about the action in the present. The action that is in the present is simple present tense. And the action is a habit or it is something that is universal true. That is shown in simple present tense sentence. For examples, you can see she cooks food. It is a habit. She cooks food. So it is simple present tense. I go to school. It is also one type of habit. I go to school. So this is also simple present tense. And the third example is the sun sets in the west. It is universal true. The sun sets in the west. So simple present tense tells us in the present time. As well, it tells us about an habit or a universal true. Now, I have said in simple present tense, we are using V1 form. So, what is the V1 form verb here? She cooks food. We know action word is called verb. So, here action word is cook. But we are using S here. Why we are using S? Because in simple present tense, third person singular. You can see on the right side one box is there, singular and plural verb. First person singular, I becomes we. Second person singular, you remains as it is you. And third person singular, he, she, it becomes they. Now in third person singular, that is he, she, it, we have to use S or ES. She is third person singular. So in the verb, we have to use S or ES. Now, I is first person singular, so we will not use S or ES. The sun is third person singular, so we are using in the verb S. Understood? So, in simple present tense, very easy to understand. Simple sentence you will have, and in the verb, if it is third person singular, you will use S or ES. Let us understand this one. As you can see here, we are having person, singular number and plural number. And we know first person singular, I becomes we in plural form. Second person, you remains as it is you in plural form. And third person singular, he, she, it becomes they in the plural form. What is the rule in third person singular? That is he, she, it, we have to use S or ES. So always remember, he, she, it, we have to use S or ES. Also, singular noun, if one boy name is there, one girl name is there, one animal or thing name is there, we have to use S or ES. See the example, I jump, we jump, you jump, but he jumps. She jumps. It jumps. If we take example of he, Ram jumps. Meena jumps. Rabbit jumps. So if the verb is in third person singular, you have to use SOREAS in the verb, and they jump. Only what you have to remember, SOREAS is used with he, she or it. Now we are having a test series to understand the uses of simple present tense. She dash an apple. You have to use simple present tense. You have to fill up with simple present tense. And we know she is third person singular. With third person singular, we are using S or ES in simple present tense. So it becomes think the answer. What it becomes? Eat. It becomes eats. She eats an apple, because in third person singular, we are using S or ES. Now next question. A monkey dash up a tree. A monkey. You have to think first person, second person or third person. We know monkey is single, one animal. So it comes in third person singular. So climb becomes think the answer, and you have to give, and the time stops. Climbs. A monkey climbs up a tree, because third person singular. The next question. We dash our homework daily. We. It is first person plural form, so we are not using S or ES. So do becomes think the answer. Do remains same as it is, because we are not using S or ES in first person plural form. So we do our homework. The next question is, her mother dash every morning. Her mother, only one mother, and mother comes in third person singular. So worship becomes think the answer, and your time started. So worship become worships. Only one third person singular. So worship becomes worships. Next question is, he dash a car. He. You have to think first person, second person or third person. And then you have to tell the answer. And your time starts. 3, 2 and 1. So the right answer is drives. He drives a car, because he is third person singular. So drive becomes drives. The next question is, they dash me in the ground. They is first person, second person or third person singular or plural form. Then you will know the answer. Think it. Your time starts. 3, 2 and 1. So the right answer is meet, because they is third person plural form. Plural form, third person plural form, we are not using S or ES. So meet remains as it is, meet. The next one is, a tailor dash a shirt. Tailor. Tailor is a person name on only one. So you have to think which it is. It is third person singular. So sieve becomes sieves, because third person singular, we have to use S or ES. The next one is, the baby dash peacefully. Baby comes in third person singular. So sleep becomes think the answer. And the right answer is sleeps, because baby comes in third person singular. So the right answer will be sleeps. The baby sleeps peacefully. In third person singular, we have to use S or ES. Next one is, Manoj dash hard to get a prize. Manoj, where it comes first, second, third person. So we know Manoj is a boy's name, and it comes only one boy. So singular, third person singular it comes. So try becomes think the answer, and your time starts. So the right answer is tries. We have to use S or ES. So, and Y means we have to use IES. So try becomes tries. The next one is, you dash to the radio. You is second person, and second person we are using S or ES. Think we are not using. So the right answer is listen. You listen to the radio. Same thing we have to use. Only third person we have to use S or ES. The next one is, a teacher dash the pupils. The teacher dash teacher, where it comes, you have to think first person, second person or third person, and tell the right answer. 3, 2 and 1. So the right answer is teachers. Teacher comes in third person singular, only one. So teacher teach become teachers. The next one is, I dash a novel in my spare time. I, it is first person, so what is the right answer? Think it and tell what is the right answer. Read becomes read. Read remains as it is, because it is first person. Read. I read a novel in my spare time. The next one is, she always dash the truth. She is third person singular. So what we have to use? Speak becomes think the answer. And the right answer is speaks. she always speaks the truth. The next one is my friend dash in Delhi. My friend means third person, it will come only one person. So my friend dash leave becomes think the answer and your time starts 3, 2, and 1. So the right answer is leaves. Leave become leaves, only one third person singular, so leave becomes leaves. The next one is Shivani dash a nice dress. Shivani is a girl's name, so it becomes in third person singular. Where becomes think the answer and your time starts 3, 2, and 1. Where becomes where. So it was very easy in third person singular, that is he, she, it. You have to use s or es. Now we will see this simple present tense we can write in three types: positive, negative, and affirmative. Positive sentence, you can see I eat an apple. In the negative form, it will become I do not eat an apple. And same affirmative means question you have to make. So question how you will make, do you will bring in front. Do I eat an apple? Same thing, you eat an apple. In negative sentence, you do not eat an apple. But in affirmative question, do you eat an apple? Next one, he, she, it eats an apple. Now he, she, it, with he, she, it, we have to use does. He, she, it, we have to use does. He, she, it does not eat an apple. Then same, does he, she, it eat an apple? Next one, we eat an apple. Negative sentence, we do not eat an apple. And question, do we eat an apple? Next one, they eat an apple. Negative sentence, how we will make? They do not eat an apple. And question, how we will make? Do they eat an apple? It is very easy to understand. Only with he, she, it, what we have to use? D-O-E-S, does. And remaining, we have to use do. If you did not understand, one video I have made, the uses of do and does, you can see in the link in the description box. Now we will go through some questions of positive, negative, and affirmative. Only you have to remember does is used with he, she, it, and remaining we have to use do. Now let us see the question. So the first question is she cooks food. She cooks food. So you have to make negative sentence. She cooks food. Think the answer how to make negative. She cooks food. Very easy. She does not. She means third person, so with he, she, it, we are using does. She does not cook food. And the affirmative will be does she cook food. Does we have to bring front. Does she cook food. The next one is we are having negative sentence. You do not dance well. You have to make positive. You do not dance well. How to make it positive? You dance well. We have to remove not. We have to remove not. You dance well. And now we are making question. So question, we have to bring do or does front. Do you dance well? Understood. The next question is we are having question, affirmative form. Do I play in the evening? Very easy. Only we have to remove do and the positive sentence will become I play in the evening. Positive sentence is I play in the evening. Now negative sentence is very easy. With I we are using do. I do not play in the evening. So it is very easy. With third person singular he, she, it, we are using does, and remaining we are using do. And how to change positive to negative and negative to affirmative, you understood. One more example we will have and then we will finish our lesson. The next one is we have to make negative and affirmative. Also we have to make positive sentence. First question is Mansi knocks at the door. Mansi knocks at the door. You have to make negative. Negative means you have to use does not or do not. So Mansi, think the answer. Mansi is third person. So Mansi does not knock at the door. Mansi is third person. With third person we have to use does or does. We have to use. Next one, affirmative questioning making. It is very easy. We will bring does in the beginning. Does Mansi knock at the door? The next one is we are having negative statement. You have to make positive sentence. You have to make. So it does not rain. It is very easy. We will remove does not and the remaining will be positive. So what is the answer? It rains. Next one is affirmative question. You have to make question. So we know in question we have to bring do or does in the beginning. So Does it rain? Next question is, you are having affirmative question you are having and you have to make positive and negative. So when you have question, it is very easy. You have to remove does and the remaining will be positive statement. So the sky grow dark. In positive, we are removing does and the remaining is positive sentence. And we know the sky, that is third person. So the sky does not grow dark. So it is very easy, simple present tense. In simple present tense, we are using V1 form. Also, we are using S or ES. And where we are using S or ES? We are using in the third person singular. What is third person singular? He, she, it. And when we are changing from positive to negative, we are using NOT, not, to change positive statement to negative sentence. And when we are making negative to affirmative, the do or does will come in the beginning and the remaining will be same as it is. And in third person singular, we are using does and remaining we are using do. So I hope you understood simple present tense. In my upcoming video, we will see present continuous tense. That's it for today, students. I hope you enjoyed this video. You can subscribe my channel to know more English grammar from Suman's Academy.